Game theory is the study of how and why people decide what to do. It's the official study of how people disagree and work together. It is a branch of mathematics that looks at how it acts in competitive situations where one person's decision has a big effect on what the other people do. Game theory has been used in business, politics, war, and all of the sciences. Game theory is a part of both the science of economics and the decisions we make about money. This is not a game of chance. It is a game of strategy in which the players try to predict each other's moves and the results of those moves. It is a way to look at how organizations, governments, and individuals should act when they need to work together. When deciding what to do, they have to think about what other people are likely to do and how they might react to what they do. BusinessDictionary.com says this about game theory. A set of ideas meant to help people make decisions when they have to deal with competition, cooperation, and dependence within the limits of rules that have already been set. Game theory doesn't use games of chance, only games of strategy, like chess. A strategic game is one in which two or more people have to make choices that affect who wins and who loses, depending on what the other players do or don't do. So, the end result of the game is decided by how each player chooses to play. In the business world, competition between two companies can be seen as a game in which the players try to get a long-term advantage, or even a monopoly, complete control of the market. Game theory helps each player come up with their own best strategy, such as how many things to make, how much to charge for them, and when to put them on the market. It can help a business figure out what its competitors will do and show the best way to respond when a competitor does something that no one saw coming. During the Cold War, the main players were the Soviet Union and the United States. Their strategic decisions were often seen as a game theory experiment. In the game, the players were the two superpowers. Game theory is about how and why people make decisions in business, or pretty much any other kind of decision, based on how much they value what they think will happen. It's not just a game at all. The players decide what to do in the game based on how much they value the possible outcomes. This is also true when a decision will only affect a single person. The field of game theory came up with zero-sum games in the 1940s. In these games, one player's win is equal to another player's loss. Game theory example of a prisoner's dilemma. By looking at prisoner's dilemma, you can see why many people think that in game theory, the smartest thing to do is to betray the other player. Imagine that two people are in jail at the same time for the same crime. Police don't know who did the crime or who helped make it happen, though. Each person who is being held has several choices. If neither prisoner talks, they will both be let go. If prisoner A betrays prisoner B, prisoner A will be set free, while prisoner B will get a long sentence. If B betrays A, B will get away with it, while A will spend a long time in prison. If they both decide to betray each other, they will both go to prison for much less time. If you only care about yourself and don't care about the other prisoner, the easiest way to make sure you don't get a long prison sentence is to betray the other prisoner. No matter what happens, your punishment will be less if you betray than if you don't. If you betray the other person and they don't tell on you, you won't have to serve your 6-month sentence. If you betray the other prisoner after he betrays you, you will get 2 years instead of 10. Simply put, betrayal is your safest strategy, so it is called the dominant strategy. Game theory says that a dominant strategy is the one that is most likely to give the player the best result, no matter what the other players do. This theory can be used to describe thousands of situations that do or could happen, like an arms race or negotiating pay. The prisoner's dilemma is like business situations that really happen. Think about a country where only Ford and Toyota make cars. They both agree to sell a certain number of cars in that country, and as long as neither of them cheats the other, they will both make a lot of money. Ford will lose market share to Toyota if it just sells the agreed-upon number of cars, and Toyota finds creative ways to sell more cars for less than duopoly rates. If Ford cheats and Toyota doesn't, Ford will get more of the market and make more money, while Toyota will lose. If Toyota cheats, it's better for Ford, and the same is true for Toyota. This is a good argument for car companies, tech giants, smartphone makers, advisors, salespeople, etc. If some of the details of the prisoner's dilemma were changed, the end result would be different. If the prisoners could sit down together, talk, and make plans for the future, they might choose to work together instead of turn on each other. The same is true if we try to solve this problem for a country instead of a prisoner. If two countries can talk to each other and make plans for the future, it makes more sense for them to work together than to betray each other. This is because both countries want to get help from the other country in the future. In the study of games, this is called a repeated game. If the players care about each other and want to help the other prisoner, they might agree to go to jail together. In real-life situations, the word game is not a good way to describe what is going on. Even though game theory is about games like chess, Monopoly, etc., the word game refers to any interaction in which the people involved share a set of rules and consequences.